Hello, beautiful souls. It's Irina again. I hope that you're not bored of me. Please let me know. But I will forgive you either way. And that is something that I would like to speak about today. It is about forgiveness. Okay, let's start. So please forgive my messy hair, okay? No, I'm joking. So let's face a fact. We all had situation where someone hurt us, right? And where you were thinking, "Oh my God, this is unforgivable. I will never forgive you this. I will never forgive you that. You have done this to me. You have done that to me." We all have that, yeah? I know. I'm getting emotional because I can recognize myself, of course. Everything that I'm talking about, it is from my perspective, my knowledge, my education, and everything that I've been through. And trust me, if I say this, that I really had situations in my life where I had to gather my strength to forgive people who I don't think that they're even sorry about the things that they have done to me. So, what I want to say here is that importance of forgiveness is immense, and why are you forgiving someone? I'm the type of person I really dislike, hate. I don't like to use the word hate because it is so strong and it doesn't exist in my world. But if I had to use the word hate, it would be to explain how much I dislike injustice, lies, any kind of injustice in general, that someone has done to me or to people in general. So I'm very sensitive about injustice and I will speak up for myself, stand up for myself, but also for other people. And so trust me if I say I had a very difficult situation that I had to get over them. Very difficult situation that I had to get over so I can find my peace. And that's the point of forgiveness. It is not about other people. It is about you. What do you need the most in your life for having one life in, let's say, harmony? It is your inner peace. So, when we speak about forgiving other people, it is not about forgiving them nor approval of their behavior, not at all, trust me. No. It just means that you understand their behavior and from what level of consciousness they operate. And that you understand why they have done something. When you don't forgive them, listen carefully, it is like giving them the power to steal your peace. And they maybe don't even think about you. They think that, oh, they have done something wrong to you and they just continue with their life, but you are the one who stays with those negative emotions. You are the one who stays with anger, with sadness, with pain, thinking, oh, how can they have done this to me? So instead of focusing on them, focus on yourself. Okay? So if someone hurts you, or in your past, instead of you're going to feel, of course, maybe even hate, you will want to revenge, you will want them to feel exactly the same things like you did. And that is okay, we are humans and it is normal to express those feelings. Don't suppress them, but just be aware that hating on others, you will not hurt them. You won't let them feel what you are feeling. You are going just to hurt yourself even more because you have those feelings within, and you must get rid of any kind of negative emotions. And the only way to get rid of negative emotions is to face them and to understand why something happened. Okay, these are like initial steps how to get over of any kind of painful situation that you are going through or that you had in your past. So how they feel shouldn't be your concern. Do they sleep well? It shouldn't be your concern. Your concern should be that you sleep well, that you don't drag your past into the present, but to face those situations and get over them so you can have your peace, so you can go to bed with your clear consciousness and with peace in your soul. That should be your goal. Okay? Not them. We all write our karma, okay? So by hurting you, I'm sure that in some kind of way it will get back to them. But it shouldn't be your concern, like I said. When you understand why something happened, you are going to set yourself free. It will be when you accept things as they are, when you accept people for who they are, you're going to set yourself self-free, and you should be focusing on yourself. Approach from understanding. That's like I mentioned in my previous video. Understand is other name for love. Okay, like I said, forgiving others, it doesn't mean that you want them back. It doesn't mean that you approve their behavior. It doesn't mean that you approve if someone is piece of the word. No, it doesn't mean that. It means that you accept even if they are piece of and of course that you don't want them back in your life, but you accept the fact, you accept the life, you accept people as they are, and focus on yourself to be a better person, to heal, first of all, to heal and to learn your lesson. Okay? So, conclusion, forgiveness is not approving. Forgiveness means accepting and understanding why something happened. If you don't want to put yourself in position that you suffer, because suffering is not necessary. It is only necessary until you realize that it's not necessary. Take your time to heal as much as you need. It is something very personal, and nobody can tell you how much time do you need to heal. It's very personal, so take time as needed. Take time to heal, take time to face the situation, and take time to get over it. How will you know that you have healed? Simply will know it that you will that you are get over something if you can speak, let's say, comfortably about it without having maybe tears in your eyes, or of course it's not going to be easy to speak about those situations, of course, but when you can speak without any difficulties, yes, that you will know that you are get over the situation. So instead of dragging your past into your present moment, and the same way in that way you're going to create the same future, please think about those situations, painful situations. Are those situations still with you in this present moment? And take time for yourself to understand why something happened. Like I said, take time to heal and Let your past in the past, because your past belongs in the past. If you drag your past with all those situations, oh my God, it's such a burden to having all that in this present moment, because all you have is this present moment, and you don't want to live this present moment with your past, with all those negative feelings, because it is going to define your life. It is going to define your personality. Just think about this. So if you are living in this present moment and you are present in this moment, what problems actually do you have? But if you live in this present moment thinking about your past, how you feel, how someone made you feel, and who knows how many situations you will have in the future, similar situations. So the importance of understanding, the importance of forgiveness is immense. It is like for your overall health important. Okay? All you want is your inner peace. If you want to have your inner peace, you have to let go of your past. You have to let go of those situations. You have to face them. That's the only way to do. You can't ignore them. No, never, never, never. You can't put, if someone says smile and everything, no. Just get away from them too. What you want is to let go of those feelings by facing them. Okay? And of course, it is not going to be easy, but it is worth it. And you will have to have strength. And God knows how much strength I had to have to get over the situation, to face the situation, to understand why something behaved like a C word. You know what word I would use. But it is necessary. It's not going to be easy, but that's the only way to do it. That's the only way. And of course, it's not going to be easy. But just let me ask you this question. Comparing to what? Is it easy to live with all those negative emotions? It's not going to be easy, but it is worth it because you are going to achieve your peace, and that's the only thing you want. You want to go to sleep. And another important thing. So, oh my God, it's another insect. No, all good, it's outside. We all had situation where someone hurt us, but we all had situation where we hurt someone. So if you are aware of that you have done something wrong to someone, please ask them for forgiveness, but not just with words. The only way to... How did you get inside? Oh my God. I'm good, everything is okay. So what I wanted to say, when you ask people, when you apologize, the only true apologize is your changed behavior, is that you are aware what you have done, that you learned your lesson, and that you changed your behavior. Saying, oh please, I'm sorry, without really meaning that, and without really feeling that, and without changing anything, it's just a sign of pure manipulation. Don't be that kind of person, please. So if you liked this video, if you find my work useful, please share it with others, like it, subscribe to my channel, and if you don't, I will forgive you, even though it is unforgivable, but I will try to understand your reasons. And till next time, I understand you. Till next time, I love you. So if you want to be at peace with yourself, and if you want to let me be at peace with myself without having to waste my time on understanding why you don't want to subscribe to my channel or share my work, do something about it, okay? Now.